still want God to be in charge. So let's all stand and go to the Lord in prayer.
Thank you,
Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, your precious Lord. Lord, your precious Lord. precious and holy Jesus.
If nobody else has come up for prayer, I want to take a minute and testify and praise God. We've been learning all week about how we can testify. We have the power and the right to testify. We've been learning all week about God is a miracle worker. We've been learning all week about how you need the Holy Ghost and you need to be filled with the Holy Ghost. We've been learning how to pray boldly all week in our lessons. These things have come up. And I just want to stand up here and praise God and thank Him. Because I had that little baby prayed for on Tuesday. He was going in. He had to see a specialist. I'm not going to tell you the details of his problem, but he had to go see a specialist. And it took us several months to get in there, about 6 months. And when I went in there, it was going kind of quick. And it wasn't just a doctor who came in there. They brought us in, and a bunch of men in the hallway said hi to us. And it wasn't even 5 minutes before that group of men came into the room. And it was a doctor and a specialist and a surgeon and something else and a student. There's like four or five of them. But he started to examine him. And he said, "I don't think he needs surgery. Do you?" He said, "I don't think you need surgery. Are you all right with that?" I said, "I say praise the Lord." Yeah. I say praise the Lord.
Yeah.
And he's a little concerned about another little part, but he said it's something that's just his age, and he just needs to grow, and that we'll check it again in a year. But you know what? I know God was able today, and God's going to be able in a year.
Yeah.
And he's touched
yes.
his heel, and he doesn't need anything else. And I praise God, and I thank Him. We should always testify about His miracles,
yes.
because you know what? Our little carnal mind, even though we should let this mind be in us, which is in Christ Jesus, our little carnal mind forgets. And He deserves to have all the glory, honor, mercy,
yes.
power, and praise.
Amen.
I love Him and I thank Him. You know what else I pray for this week? A break in the weather. My mommy's coming in today and I needed a break in the weather. And God's given us that break. I love Him and I praise Him and I thank Him for all that He does.
Yes.
From the biggest thing to the littlest thing.
Yes.
We should have our trust in Him.
Yes.
He's the one we should be trusting in.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Well, what exactly were you praying for today?
I was praying that God would give me a miracle.
I know. miracle.
I want God to give me a piece of chocolate cake and some chocolate ice.
That's the miracle you want?
Yes, that's the miracle I want. I was ready to give a testimony about it too.
Well, you do realize that asking for a piece of cake isn't exactly what God has in mind when you pray, right?
I thought so, but I was hoping He would grant me this one miracle because I was really hungry.
Well, oh my, Brother Larry, what are we going to do with you? You know, I think we have the perfect lesson for you coming up tonight.
Really? Is it about miraculous cakes?
No, it's not about that. It's about praying bold prayers, not prayers about cakes.
Oh, okay. I still wish I had a piece of cake.
Well, you might be a little bit surprised to learn that I have your little slack plate, and guess what it is?
Wow! I love cupcakes.